Have you ever wondered how WebDriver.js works? Well, in this video, we'll go over the proper way of understanding WebDriver.js. I have a directory with the Selenium WebDriver node module already installed. I also have a node script that does the following. Open a Safari browser and go to wikipedia.org. Find the search input and fill in the text WebDriver. Find and click the Go button. Get and log the page title. And finally, quit the driver. As a point of reference, I'm going to log the text end as the last thing in my script. Also, I'm going to add some pause points in between the commands just to make it easier to follow along. Now I'm going to save my changes and run the script. The first thing you'll notice is that the console.log end happens first before any of the WebDriver commands. For those who are familiar with a blocking or synchronous language like Java, Python, or Ruby, you might expect the code to run line by line. But JavaScript, on the other hand, is different because the language is non-blocking and uses an asynchronous event loop. WebDriver.js takes full advantage of this by using promises. Let me prove that to you. In my command line, I will first set the environment variable selenium_browser to phantom.js and then type node to open the node.js REPL. I will load my script, which will run all the code inside my REPL. You can see that the last line with the console.log has been reached. Now is where things get interesting. If I search for the driver.get method, you can see that the command returns a promise. And the same result can be observed with driver.findElement chained with the click and send keys methods, driver.getTitle, driver.sleep, and driver.quit. For those who don't know what a promise is, it is an object that represents a value or the eventual computation of a value. It works with the WebDriver API because when a command is called, it can happen either immediately or after some time. So promises allow us to chain other commands together and is a much cleaner way of doing things compared to continuation passing, which uses callbacks. Also, the promises are managed by control flow that further improves the readability of the code. To understand how the promise manager works, imagine there's a queue. Every time a WebDriver command is called, the task gets scheduled into the queue. Then, whenever the driver starts up, they are executed one after another until the queue is done. To prove a point, I'm going to refactor the script to use the internal promise library instead of the promise manager and register the observers with the then function. Don't forget to return a promise if you want to continue the promise chain. If nothing or undefined is returned, then the promise chain ends. Now I'm going to refactor the rest of the commands. Looking at driver.getTitle, it should now make sense why there's a .then function with the first argument as a title value. Also, to prove another point, I can break up the click method from the findElement method. In the following thenable, the Go button is now passed as the first argument and you can call the click method on it. Running the refactored script, you can see the same results as before. And that's a quick overview of how the WebDriver.js API works.